Hello, and welcome to this tutorial on the electrical installation of the people counter. Today we will show how to set up the people counter, including a tower light and a push-button control station. There is a pre-wired set with the above-mentioned parts. The part number is 111-4292. Optionally, you can order a push-button control station with it. However, if you want to do the wiring yourself, it will be explained step by step in the following. To complete the electrical installation, you will need the following hardware and tools. An MRS-1000 people counter and its Ethernet cable. A SICK connection box. A tower light and its cable. A 3 push button control station and its cable. A power supply with 5 pin M12 adapter cable. An Ethernet to USB adapter. And finally, the use of a Phillips screwdriver and a slotted screwdriver. You can find all the needed components on SICK.com, except the 3 push-button control station and its cable. Those two items will have to be purchased from an electrical supply store or online reseller. The overall wiring of the people counter, tower light and push-button control station is shown in this wiring diagram. The people counter and the SICK connection box are linked using pre-installed cables with M12 connectors. The other accessories have to be wired manually within the SICK connection box. Open the SICK connection box and attach the label marked pin definition MRS-1000/LMS-1000 to the inside of the lid. Now we connect the tower light with the SICK connection box using the included 10-meter cable with an M12 connector. Pass the cable for the tower light through the left cable gland as shown. We will then connect the 4 wires to pins in the SICK connection box. The brown wire is connected to pin 9. This wire provides power to the red light and is used to indicate the room capacity is reached or exceeded. The white wire is connected to pin 10. This wire provides power to the orange light and is used to indicate the warning threshold is reached or exceeded, but still below room capacity. The black wire is connected to pin 11. This wire provides power to the green light and is used to indicate that the number of persons in the room is below the warning threshold. The light blue wire is connected to pin 15. This wire is the common for all the lights. Now we can connect the M12 connector to the tower light. The next step is to connect the cable for the 3 push button control station within the SICK connection box using a 4 conductor cable with flying leads. Like the push button control station, this cable is not available from SICK and must be purchased separately. Please pass the cable through the last open cable gland as shown. We are now ready to wire the people counter's inputs. Please record the wire colors of your cable because you will need them to wire the push button control station. Pin 14 is for the input that increases the number of people in the room. In our example, we use a black wire for this input. Pin 16 is for the input that decreases the number of people in the room. In our example, we use a dark blue wire for this input. Pin 21 is for the input that sets the number of people in the room to 0. In our example, we use a white wire for this input. Pin 17 provides power for the push button control station. In our example, we use a brown wire for this purpose. After that, we wire the push button control station. Open the push button control station. Make sure there is a suitable cable gland for the cable. In our example, we had to install one. Disconnect all pre-installed wires. Connect one side of the normally open or NO contacts on all 3 switches together. Pass the 4 conductor cable with flying leads through the cable gland. Connect the wire that provides power for the push button control station to one of the contacts just wired together. The wire is connected to pin 17 in the SICK connection box. In our example, we use a brown wire for this purpose. Now it's time to connect the other side of the normally open contacts on the switches. On the switch you want to use to increase the number of people in the room, please connect the wire that is connected to pin 14 in the SICK connection box. In our example, we use a black wire for this purpose. On the switch you want to use to decrease the number of people in the room, Please connect the wire that is connected to pin 16 in the ZIC connection box. In our example, we use a dark blue wire for this purpose. On the switch you want to use to set the number of people in the room to 0, please connect the wire that is connected to pin 21 in the ZIC connection box. In our example, we use a white wire for this purpose. Now you can close the push button control station. Now we connect the people counter to the ZIC connection box using two of the three pre-installed cables with M12 connectors. Connect the left cable to the port labeled PWR, or power, on the people counter. This cable provides power. Connect the right cable to the port labeled IO on the people counter. This cable connects the inputs and outputs. The middle cable is not needed for the people counter application. To supply everything with power, we use the cable gland at the end of the ZIC connection box. Please feed the flying lead end of the cable with the 5-pin M12 connector on the other end through this cable gland. Now we wire the power supply cable to the ZIC connection box. The brown wire is connected as a second wire to pin 17. This wire provides power to the entire people counter solution. The light blue wire is connected to pin 18. This wire is common for the entire people counter solution. The remaining wires are not needed and should be properly insulated and secured within the ZIC connection box. Please tighten all cable glands to assure moisture and dust tight connections and proper strain relief of the cables. Now you can close the ZIC connection box. In case you want to configure the people counter, please connect the Ethernet cable between the people counter and a PC. For more information on our people counter, please see our other videos. Solutions from ZIC to provide an added value to our society.